Oh my gosh, you're here. I don't know what happened just now. I think I got disconnected. Can you guys see me? Can you guys let me know if you can see me right now? Hi. Can you guys see this? Is it working, guys? Is it working? Can you guys see me? Hello? Can you guys see me? If you can see me, can you guys write like a heart? Oh my God, so many of you guys are commenting and I have no idea if you can see me or not. Oh, you guys can, oh, you can see me. Yeah! Woohoo! Are you guys excited? Hi, guys! Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Oh man, that was so stressful trying to get that working. Oh my gosh, YouTube was giving me trouble. I had to do the thumbnail, upload everything, and it was just like taking forever. What is up, you guys? Oh my God, so many of you are here. It's so exciting. Happy Valentine's Day. I've got my flowers. I've got my chocolates. Are you guys so excited? Oh my God, we're running a little bit behind, but it's gonna be such a fun time. Oh my gosh. Nikki and Matt are coming over in a little bit. Nathan's downstairs. We just got Cassie to bed. So you guys have been sending me mortifying moments all day long, and I have been reading them, and oh my gosh, you guys, so many mortifying moments. I can hardly believe it. Happy Valentine's Day, guys. Oh my goodness. Oh man, I was so worried that that wasn't going to work. Because the first time I tried it, I came online and I could see all of your comments and I could see all your likes and stuff, but then it just stopped all of a sudden. So I had to like go back and do a new thumbnail, and, like type it all in again. And, let's just like keep our fingers crossed that the Wi-Fi and everything will be good today. Happy Valentine's Day to you too. Oh my gosh, you guys are so many comments. I love you guys. Yeah, guys, it was supposed to start at 8, but I'm running a little bit behind. I'm so sorry about that. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, hearts. Hi, Maya. Hey, Liberty. Hey, Forever Rose. What am I doing today for Valentine's Day? Well, guess what, guys? I'm here with you. This is what I'm doing for Valentine's Day. I've had such a busy week, actually, because I'm a relationship therapist. You guys know that. And this time of year, things get really busy for me because I'm, like, running all around the place, like, giving advice on TV usually. So yeah, it can be, like, a really busy time for me. But I was like, no matter what, I'm not making plans for Valentine's Day night because, like, I want to be here with you guys. And I know some of you are single, some of you are in relationships, but I feel like our relationship, like, as a fam is so strong. I know that sounds, like, super cheesy, but it's true. So you guys are my Valentine, so I really wanted to have this day with you to spend, like, hang out. We have some mortifying moments to dish. We have some chatting with Nikki. We've got some ice cream cake and some fun and some food and stuff downstairs that we're gonna go in a little bit downstairs, and I'll, like, introduce you to everybody and stuff. Hi! Hey, guys! How's it going? Happy Valentine's Day! Hello, single people! Hi! Oh my goodness! You guys are so awesome! It's so great to see all of you! So can you guys tell me where you're from? Write a comment and let me know what part of the world are you from? What part of the world are you watching from? I'm in Toronto. Where are you guys? Ireland! Oh my God, it's beautiful in Ireland! Oh, thank you, love my hair. Puerto Rico, Canada, the UK, North Carolina, Wisconsin, Kentucky, Texas, Tasmania, Idaho, Iowa, United States, Texas, Indiana, Connecticut, Washington, D.C., Tampa, Florida, Pennsylvania, Virginia, Florida, Virginia, North America, Austin, Ohio, Ecuador, Tunisia, Mexico, Maine, B.C., yeah, I was born in B.C., Toronto, Oh my gosh, you guys, I can't even keep up with it. There's so many of you here. I am so excited. You guys know, like, Valentine's Day is like my Christmas, I'm telling you. I look forward to it so much every year, and I get so excited because it's like a day to celebrate the love in your life. It doesn't have to be like a boyfriend or a girlfriend or anything. It's just about, you know, celebrating the people in your life and the love that you do have. And I think that that's why it's important that we all celebrate it. So, you know, today, this is like a Galentine's Day. And obviously I love my Ask Kimberly guys as well, but we're having like, you know, a little party here. It's not about like us being all lovey-dovey and romantic and whatnot. It's about like chilling together and having fun and like eating candy, and, like doing everything pink. I'm so excited. Yeah. When does my giveaway end? Which giveaway are you talking about? We had a huge 200,000 subscriber giveaway, and that giveaway was recently announced, which was really cool. The giveaway from Honey, the outfit Valentine's Day giveaway, is going to be announced on March 15th. So it gives everyone enough time to actually enter the giveaway, which I like because it gives you guys enough time to actually... The Honey one. Okay, perfect. That's exactly it. I love that video so much, and I love the store Honey. We worked so hard on that video. I'm so glad you guys loved it. Northern Ireland. Oh my gosh, I can't even keep up with the comments. You guys are just, oh, you're bringing it. I'm so happy you're here. Thank you guys so much for coming. Aw, thank you guys so much. So I was thinking maybe we could start off the night, this Valentine's night, with some mortifying moments, like embarrassing moments. And by the way, you guys, if you are actually new to this channel, so if you're a new subscriber, if you've never been here before, I should give you like a brief background. My name is Kimberly. I'm a relationship expert and therapist, and I give like relationship advice on my channel. So most of you, I'm assuming, are like my subscribers, my fam. But if you're new, like, welcome to the fam. And guys, before we even get into today, like, make sure and do it right now if you can. Go onto your phone or your computer and click that little notification bell so that actually when I upload, so because YouTube has changed a whole lot of things on their platform, and it's like now people, like some people aren't getting notified when I upload a new video. So if you haven't done that already, go do it right now because like it'll help you actually get notified when I do upload a new video. The other thing is I am actually thinking about doing live videos more often. So like, you know, today for Valentine's Day, it's kind of like a little test run. You guys can let me know if you like it. But I love the idea of doing like live Q&As with you guys because, you know, you have so many questions, and I feel so bad when we do Q&As and there are literally thousands of questions and there's so many amazing questions, and I feel bad that I can't answer everything. And that's one thing that actually eats me up inside so much of the time, is that I try so hard to get to everyone's questions, and I love you guys and I want to help all of you, but like I literally can't even open or read all of the questions that you send. So that's one thing. Let me know if you guys want to do these live things more often, because I feel like it will give me a chance to get to more of those questions that you have. And I know a lot of you guys are in love situations and relationship situations. So I would love to be able to kind of help out more often. Oh my gosh, lots of hearts. My God, you guys, I love you guys. Oh, do more. Everyone's saying do more. Amazing. Oh, you guys are so cute. Thank you for all the nice comments. I'm so excited. This is like a day of love. And, for anyone who hasn't been a member of the Ask Kimberly family long, like one thing you've probably felt like right off the bat, one thing that I strongly feel is that this is like a family. Like everyone supports each other. Like whenever I look at the comments, I see you guys like commenting on comments, and you guys are helping each other. And like, there's literally nothing that makes me happier than that, to see you guys just helping one another, and to know like we have all created together like something that's really beautiful, where people are coming together and like helping one another. And I love YouTube as a platform, and I've seen a lot of other YouTubers do amazing things, but one thing I believe about Ask Kimberly is that like this is just so unique. Like I have never experienced another like kind of YouTube culture like the one that we have. So thank you guys for being so awesome. Like I'm like the luckiest YouTuber in the whole world, because you know I'm so lucky to have all of you guys, and for all of you guys to be participating. So while I did an Instagram post earlier today asking you guys for mortifying moments, and I chose a few that I thought were, oh, freaking so mortifying. I have a couple mortifying moments of my own. So are you guys, tell me if you guys are ready for some mortifying moments. Are you guys ready? Tell me in the comments. Are you guys ready? And if you have, okay, guys, there are some, just give me 1 second. Anytime I see like a spammy comment, it's really hard because you guys are commenting so quickly, but if I see spammy comments, I'm just going to like quickly delete them and get rid of them. So hopefully that's not too disruptive here, but you guys are all amazing. Okay, you guys are ready. Oh my God, yay. Okay, so some of these mortifying moments are crazy, and I have some too. If you guys want to type some of your mortifying moments here, go ahead. And oh my God, it's going so quickly though. I honestly don't even know if I'll be able to read it. I'm just going to pull up a couple of the ones that I have seen in there. Oh my God. So embarrassing. Okay. The first one, you guys, is from Jenna Backer. Jenna, are you here? Because I'm about to read your mortifying moment, and it's bad. It is bad. Jenna, are you here? Let us know if you're here, Jenna. Oh, Jenna says, okay, here it goes. I was talking in a group and my crush was there. About an hour prior to this, I had eaten an ice cream cone, which was a terrible idea because I'm lactose intolerant. Oh boy. Here we go. Anyways, he said something funny. Oh, hi, Kira. How's it going? Anyways, he said something funny and everyone in the group laughed. I laughed so hard that I farted. It was really embarrassing and I never spoke to that crush again. Damn that ice cream cone. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Has anybody farted in front of their crush before? Because oh my God, my makeup. I can't let it run. I have the whole night to get through. But has anyone farted in front of their crush before? Because I don't think that's ever happened to me, but oh my God, that sucks. I'm so sorry that happened to you. Prayers for her. Oh my God. Oh my God, you guys, the comments are crazy. This is so good. As well, she says, I die. Oh shoot, I forgot to put my phone on airplane mode. Oops. Okay, oh my God. The comments are killing me right now. Oh my God, poor Jenna. Yeah, exactly. My crush farted in front of me. Oh my God, let's go back to that one. How do I do this? My crush farted in front of me and it was so funny, but I didn't care because he is too cute. Aw, that's a good person right there. I feel like, yeah, poor Jenna. Everybody farts though, come on. It's only human, but I guess it's not really the best thing to happen in front of your crush. Oh, man. If you guys are new, if you're just joining, this is Ask Kimberly. This is a relationship channel, and we're dishing all about mortifying crush moments. So I asked people to submit mortifying moments on Instagram earlier, and we're just reading some of them out right now, like the most mortifying, embarrassing things that have happened in relationships or crushes, and it's freaking so funny. Why are the cute guys always jerks? By the way, happy Valentine's Day, you guys. I love you all. Poor Jenna. Yeah, no kidding. Oh, huge fan. I love you guys. Okay, should I read another one? What do you guys think? I have a couple here. Actually, okay, here's the deal. I have an embarrassing moment that happened when I was a little kid. You guys want to hear it? What should we do? Do you guys want to hear one of my embarrassing moments, or do you want to hear the next one I chose? Yes. Oh, man. Okay, well, the good thing about mine is that it happened when I was so young that it's almost like I can't, like, I can push it out of my mind. So I'm about to tell you guys, like, my most embarrassing crush moment ever. This happened... This is bad, too. So, when I was in grade one... All started in grade one. There was a boy. If he's out there in the world, I don't know. I honestly don't know what ever happened to this guy, but I'm going to tell you his name. You guys can Google him if you want. I don't know what happened to him. His name is Robbie Reedman. Okay? He was the kindergarten and grade one stud muffin. And when I was in grade one, my best friend Vicky and I, we used to fight over Robbie Reedman because he was a hottie. He had, like, a bowl cut, blonde hair, blue eyes, and one day, you guys are gonna go Google Robbie. I have no idea what happened to the guy, honestly. I haven't seen him since. I moved schools when I was in grade two, so I don't know what happened, but good thing, because my story is so embarrassing. So, what happened was, I decided that I loved Robbie Reedman. And my parents told me that they would help me write a love letter to him. I don't think it was Valentine's Day. I was just, like, a really romantic kid, and I decided, okay, I want to, like, profess my love to Robbie. So, my parents sat me down, and I wrote a card, and it was a big heart, and it had two people kissing on the front, and it said, "I love you, Robbie. Will you marry me? You are the best. I love you so much." And then it was like, mwah. Savage, I know. And on top of this, like, my best friend and I were, like, literally fighting over this guy. So I was like, I want Robbie Reedman to like me so badly. So I went to school the next day and gave him this card, which nowadays, like, it would be so horrendous, but it was grade one, so I was like, whatever, I like him. I'm just gonna tell him I like him. So I went to school, and I gave him my card, and he threw it on the ground. Savage, I know. No, guys, this gets better. I'm telling you, this gets better. Robbie is savage. I know. So, I'm a little bit sick, you guys. He's a bad man. I know. So, he threw the card on the ground, and I was like, oh, no. You know, what's gonna happen? Like, does he not like me? Sorry, guys. But the worst part is that during class, the teacher saw the note on the ground. And she picked it up, and she read it in front of the whole class. I know, right? Worst day of my life in grade one, I'm telling you. I was so embarrassed, and not only did the love of my life not pan out in grade one, but my teacher also embarrassed me, and then the whole class knew who my crush was, and I was mortified. But honestly, the teacher is evil. I know, right? Freaking crazy. I could not believe it. I was like, now looking back, I'm like, what kind of a teacher does that to their grade one student? I was like six. Robbie Reedman sucks. No. Guys, honestly, I'm sure he's a very nice guy. Oh, it is okay. I am fully over it. You guys do not need to hate on Robbie at all. It was grade one. I'm sure he was totally embarrassed that he got a love letter in the first place. Savage Apple. Oh my God. I know. Life got better from there. Dating got better from there for me. And if I've learned anything, guys, of all the relationships I've had in my life, that I'm still glad, like, if I can come up with some kind of philosophical story behind this, I'm just glad that even in grade one, I, like, put myself out there. So I think if you do like someone and you have feelings for them, like, put yourself out there. Like, it doesn't hurt. And I learned from it. I was like, okay, I'm never going to write something in paper form again like that because someone can get their hands on it. I think you're talking about my dad. Oh, no. Oh, my goodness. Okay, guys, are you ready for another mortifying moment? Because I have another one. And are you guys ready? Do you guys want to hear another one? Oh, my God, you guys are coming up with so many amazing stories. I love it. Yes, are you guys ready? Are you guys ready for another one? Daughter of Robbie. Oh, my God. Okay, you're ready. All right, so the next one is from Rachel Dare. Oh, and by the way, I forgot to tell you guys, the winner, the person... Okay, so, like, after this is all over, if you guys, in the comments right now, write your most embarrassing moment, because after this is all finished, I'm going to go through all of them, including on Instagram, and I'm going to choose a winner, okay, for, like, the most embarrassing, mortifying moment, and the winner is going to win a Kylie Jenner lip kit in the shade of Love Bite, okay? So start dishing your mortifying moments. I might be able to read them now, but the good thing is that even if I don't see it right now, I'm going to read through all of them later, and I'm going to decide on a winner for, like, most mortifying moment, okay? The Kylie Jenner lip kit in Love Bite is, like, the cutest shade ever. For me, I feel like it's kind of a Valentine's Day shade. It's super lovey-dovey. It's super cute. So start telling stories, and I will read through all of them after this. Okay, so the second one, guys, is from Rachel Dare 13. She says, when I was in grade 6, actually, I'm going to plug in my phone, too, because I feel like I'm going to start losing battery soon. Just give me a second. I want to make sure that we are good to go. Okay. It's looking awfully dark. Just want to make sure it's not going to stop. Okay. Rachel Dare says, when I was in the sixth grade, I got a stomach bug or something. There was a cute boy in my class and my teacher assigned partners, and it turned out that we got to work together. I felt really sick, but I was excited to be working with him. Can you guys see where this might be going? Ooh. This is gonna get bad. Oh my goodness. Here we go, guys. He started talking about his new shoes that were super expensive. Oh, God. And the next thing I knew, I had thrown up all over his shoes. Oh, my God. And she says, it's been 3 years and he still won't talk to me. Yeah, no wonder. Oh my God. He was like talking about how expensive his shoes were and then she threw up all over his shoes. That is so embarrassing, Rachel. Oh my God. Oh my gosh, you guys. If you guys are just tuning in, I'm just going to do a quick recap. This is Ask Kimberly. It's a relationship channel. If you're new here, I give relationship advice. We have like the best community in the world. And right now we are having like a Valentine's Day party / celebration Q&A. And we are also looking at mortifying moments. Like people are sharing their most mortifying crush and dating moments. So I'm reading out some of the top ones that I saw on Instagram earlier today, but I am also going to be reading through all of the comments later on, and the winner for most mortifying moment is actually going to win a Kylie Jenner lip kit in the shade of Love Bite. So definitely keep sharing, you guys. Oh my God, Rachel, that's so embarrassing. Oh my gosh, what videos are you planning to do soon? Oh my gosh, you guys, I have so many fun videos coming up. The best one I'm excited, the one I'm most excited about is how to bend and snap. Are you guys excited for that one? It's taken me so long to actually get that video ready because I want it to be so good for you guys. Bend and snap. Oh my God. Okay, I can see the comments are coming in. I love you guys. I really want to get that one right because bend and snap is like I think it's like an art. And yes, you can do it sexily, and it is a real thing. It's not just super cheesy. So I think it's something that it's going to be an awesome video. I'm going to do that as a collab with my friend, my girlfriend, Rachel David. You guys might know her. She's another YouTuber as well. And guys, in a few minutes, Nikki and Matt, so Nikki Health and Nutrition, who we did the honey video with, like the outfit one for Valentine's Day, she is coming over. So she should be here shortly, and we are going to continue the celebration at my place. I also, do you guys want to do like a closet tour? Like, we can't do it right now because we have other stuff on the agenda. But we're currently in my closet. I don't know if you guys want to see this. Do you guys want to see my closet? Yes. Do you guys want to take a quick look around? And then I was thinking about maybe giving you guys a little closet tour, like as a video. I can show you guys my makeup and stuff and like where I store everything. The fun thing about my closet is that I actually got to design it because, we moved into this house like a year ago and did some renovations to the top floor. And I literally got to like draw out a plan for the architect, and they literally, I don't know if you guys can see this, but it's like super customized. Like it's, ah, there I am right there. And yeah, so you can see like, I have like kind of space for everything that I need. And I just love it. I have some like really, I will show you guys the rest later, like the front part. Oh, you guys like it? Oh, thank you. Oh, sorry, I'm just going to block somebody quickly. Remove, report. There we go. Yeah, thanks, guys. I was excited that I got to design it. I got to design it because I have a lot of clothes. I love fashion. I love jewelry. I love accessories. Oh, I blocked someone because they were, if there's anyone that comes in here and, oh, see another one. If anyone, remove. So guys, you might be asking why I'm blocking people right now. It's just because once in a while, this happens all the time on Instagram Live or even Periscope. People will come on, and sometimes say things that are, oh, you guys are reporting too. Okay, if you guys can report them, that would be awesome. I would really love that because I don't want to keep stopping and starting. So if you guys can just keep reporting the nasty people, that would be amazing. Yeah, this happens all the time. Like, it's just a thing where if someone comes and they're not like an actual Ask Kimberly subscriber, they might say some things that are like, you know, nasty or whatever. And don't worry about it. Like, this is totally, normal on YouTube and Instagram Live. So no worries. I actually don't care about it at all. But if you guys can help me out, I would love it. Okay, you guys, so are you ready for one more mortifying moment from Instagram? This one is bad. It's so bad. It's so bad. Are you guys ready? I'm going to share it with you. Okay, here it comes, you guys. You ready? Yes? Oh, did I accidentally report you? Oh my God, I'm so sorry. No, I am not live on Instagram right now. I am, right now I am live on YouTube, guys, but I do Instagram lives once in a while. Oh, you guys are awesome. Thank you for reporting. Yeah, I'm a little bit sick. I have something mortifying actually happened to me last night. It was crazy. If you guys are new, if you're just joining, this is Ask Kimberly. This is a relationship channel here on YouTube. I have the best fam in the whole world. Happy Valentine's Day. I have some friends coming over in a little bit. We're having a party. We're sharing mortifying moments. We're dishing the dirt. And I love you guys so much. So, yeah. Oh my God, Sydney, you know it. You know it. I had a dry mouth. Oh, you guys are so funny. Were you watching my Snapchats? It was so embarrassing. But the funny thing is, I don't think anyone actually ended up noticing. I don't know, like, a lot of people, nobody mentioned it to me, and, like, a lot of people saw the segment, and they were like, everybody knows it was my dry mouth. It was crazy. I was on TV last night to talk about tips for Valentine's Day, and I go on TV a lot, so, like, it's not something I get nervous about anymore, but literally because I'm sick, I was on TV, and I just, like, kept talking, and then all of a sudden, like, my mouth was, like, it's like I couldn't talk because there was no, like, it was just the so dry. I don't know if I can communicate, like, what I experienced, but it was, like, actually, I had to, like, keep going like this, and I feel like I could even hear it. It was, like making noise. It was so embarrassing. And I just, like, kept talking and going like that, like, in the segment, and I got through it, and it worked out fine, but yeah, that's never happened to me before. I think it was just because, like, I had to take, like, Advils and stuff before I went on just to, like, clear the sinuses, and I think that might have affected it, but I don't know. So, guys, the last mortifying moment, and I think Nikki and Matt are going to be here soon, is from Alyssa Pontes. She says, last year, are you guys ready? Am I going brunette? I don't know what I'm doing with my hair right now. I have naturally brown hair, and I always get highlights. I have little highlights right now. I think I'll probably always be blonde, but I like to switch up the colors every now and again. So we'll see. Oh, you guys are ready. Okay. So Alyssa Pontes. Oh, is that Alyssa that just said that? Amazing. She says, last year in sixth grade, I was sitting... Okay, wait, this is embarrassing. I was sitting by my crush, and I had a very bad cold, and I was trying to flirt with him. He said something. Oh my god, this is gonna get bad. Okay. Alyssa. Oh, girl. He said something that made me laugh. And a big bloody ass booger shot out of my nose and landed right onto my paper. And he saw it all happen. Wah. Oh, Alyssa, girl. Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness. Hello from Brazil. Hi. Oh, my gosh. Poor Alyssa. Oh my gosh. Well, at least, Alyssa, this was last year, and you have had some time to recover from this. Oh my goodness, I feel so bad for you. I don't think that's ever happened to me. Has that ever happened to you guys? Like, sneezing and, like... Oh, one time... Okay, I don't know if you guys have ever noticed this, or if you guys know what video it is. You're gonna maybe look now. But there was one week that I had a cold, and I shot a YouTube video. And I have someone who helps me with my editing. I edit a lot of it myself, but then there's somebody who kind of comes in once in a while and does some of, like, when I'm really, really busy, they'll help me with some of the, like, the basic editing. And I didn't actually know it, but I had a booger in my nose, like, the whole video. And I didn't even know it until, I actually saw, like, the finished product, and I was like, oh no. And then I was like, well, I've already filmed it, I've already put so much work into it, and, like, we've already edited it, like, I'm not just gonna not put it out for you guys. So I just put it out anyway, and nobody really said anything, and I'm sure you guys are gonna find it, but honestly, I didn't care that much. Like, I'm not that embarrassed. Like, if there's a booger in my nose, whatever. It wasn't the end of the world. Or you guys are telling me to report someone. Oh, I love you guys all so much. Report Jack. I actually can't. You guys keep saying this. Okay. Oh, here he is. I'm gonna report him. Just a second, guys. Report. Ah, sorry. Okay, give me one sec, you guys. Why are people like this? I don't understand. Love you, love you, love you. Get a job? Someone told me to get a job. Do you want to know something, Jack? You want to know what my job is? Jack, I have a PhD, so, it's okay, you guys, this does not hurt my feelings at all. It is all good. Jack, I own a therapy clinic, and there are 25 therapists working there. I started it when I was 25, almost 10 years ago, and I'm super proud of what I do. And now, on YouTube, I freaking love this community so much. You guys are the best people in the whole world, and I don't make YouTube, like, here's one thing. I think a lot of people have weird assumptions about YouTube. They'll be like, oh, YouTubers make videos in their room because they're, like, bored and they have nothing better to do and they want to make money and they don't have any other way to do it. Let me tell you guys. You know, when I started YouTube, I had to take time away from so many of the other things that I was doing because I was like, I want to be doing this. Like, I love the people who watch my channel, and, like, you guys fuel me. Like, you know, I love my work, but I love this too, and I don't do this because I'm bored. I feel like it's something that's so special, and that I'm supposed to be doing it, and I love you guys. Like, yeah. Seriously, it's been such a process, and yeah, it has nothing to do with, with any of that stuff. For me, it's more about feeling passion towards something and knowing that you guys, like, that our community is growing and that all of us have such a great relationship together. And I do this just because I'm so passionate about it and I love it. And, I think that our community is going to continue growing and continue getting better and better and better. And we will, Jack is back. Oh no, what the heck, you guys? Don't worry about it. Guys, we can report them, but at the same time, like, I don't even care. Like, just ignore the comments. It's not that big a deal. So that's fine. You have to block his profile. Oh. Yes, what's my PhD in? So I have a doctoral degree. So it's a DC psych in psychology. I spent 14 years in university, so I did, like, a 5-year undergraduate degree, a 2-year master's, and a 7-year doctoral degree, so you guys can call me Dr. Kimberly or Dr. Moffitt if you want to. I studied, yes, I will definitely upload this, I think this video will be, oh my god, that is not a fake-ass degree, Jack. Okay, seriously, what the hell. Remove. You guys, I spent a really long time in university, and what are my experiences as a psychologist? I'm not actually a psychologist because I decided that I love the business and education side of psychology more than I love the actual practicing. So I'm not actually in practice anymore, but I was in practice as a psychotherapist for a while and a counselor for a while. And now I've moved on to, like, more of a business and administrative role. And I communicate with you guys through YouTube, and I do consulting as well. So that's kind of what I love to do now, but I feel like there's, as we go in our careers, no, not school for nothing, don't worry, that was my own decision. So, yeah, that was absolutely something that I wanted to do, and I'm really happy with the path that I've chosen. And I think, like, as we go throughout our careers, like, we have to follow our interests and our passions, and if we just do what everyone else is doing, like, in my field, everybody else was just becoming a psychologist, and they work all these years, and, like, you know, they become a psychologist, and that's it. But for me, it was like, no, I want to make a difference, and I want to do something that no other people with this kind of education are doing. And so that is why I decided to do what I did. Oh, somebody's here.
Hello. Hey.
Hi.
Are Nikki and Matt here?
Yeah, it's 9:15.
Oh, I didn't hear them come in.
Yeah.
Oh, guys, this is Nathan. You want to say hi? Come in.
Hi.
Are you guys ready to go downstairs? I didn't know. Everyone's like, who dat, who dat? Okay, you guys, are you ready to go downstairs? Let's do this. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody. Do you want to grab the chocolates?
Sure.
We can eat them when we go downstairs. You guys are so awesome. Okay, so here we go. Go through my closet. And I didn't actually hear them come in, so just excuse me for a minute. Hello downstairs of your house. Okay, guys, here we go. We're going to go downstairs. Okay, let's go. Woohoo! Oh, do you guys recognize this place? That's where we film the videos. Okay, we're going downstairs. Hello, guys.
Hey.
Hello.
Hello.
You guys want to say hi?
I did not hear you guys come in, so I was like, I was in my closet upstairs answering questions.
In your closet?
Yes, it was in my closet.
You were walking.
I was going to say, like, it's the only place I'd be, too.
You look so cute. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, happy Valentine's Day. Give me a hug.
Hey, happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
How's your last week going?
Too. It's going good. Oh. Hello. Good. Okay, you guys, so.
This got the boys here.
We've got the boys. This is Nikki.
Hi, guys.
Do you guys remember Nikki from our Valentine's Day outfit video with Honey? Yeah?
Guys were in it too, which is nice too.
Yeah, the guys were in it too.
It's a reunion.
And it's a reunion. This is Matt. This is Nikki's boyfriend. Do you guys recognize him from the video as well? He was in the flower shop and at Butter Avenue, the macaron.
Yeah.
The macaron shop.
So delicious.
Yeah, and this is Nathan, guys, my husband.
I live here.
Yes, he does. I don't know if you guys can see this in the background, but our Christmas tree is actually still up.
The Valentine's Day.
Oh, no. That's where it lives.
It lives there. It's just up all year. No. It's not up all year round. It's just that we've actually been so busy, and I would rather spend 2 hours filming and putting out a video for you guys than taking down my Christmas tree. My kid? Where's my kid? She's in bed. What time is it? It's like quarter to nine.
It's quarter to nine.
It's quarter to nine. She's in bed. But yeah, I would rather spend the time putting out videos, and we will take down the tree when winter is over. Yeah. That's how I see it.
That was plus 5 today, so.
Yeah. I guess we're gonna have to do that. Okay, so guys, we are talking like mortifying moments, and we just shared a few upstairs in my closet. They were insane. Like, people on Instagram were sharing like really mortifying moments. Like, one girl sneezed and a booger came and lit in front of her crush, and the booger landed on her paper.
I'm mortified for you. Oh my god.
I know, isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
And then one girl was sick, and her crush was like bragging about his new shoes that he just got and how expensive they were, and she barfed all over his shoes.
Oh,
so that's pretty embarrassing too, right?
Oh my god.
And then another girl, I think they ate ice cream. I can't remember exactly what the comment was, but like, they ate ice cream and she's lactose intolerant, so he said something funny and she farted like really loud.
I'm not gonna say which friend. I actually had a friend recently. She was like, I don't think she was actually interested romantically in the guy, but she, you know, she was a cute boy and she was talking to him and she accidentally let one out, and she just kind of kept talking over it as if nothing happened, but she's like, he definitely heard it.
Oh my god.
I would be mortified. Like, I don't know.
Well, we were saying earlier, like, everybody farts, like, it is normal, but it's not something like
it's not a good first impression.
It's hard. Even like, if I was to like fart in front of Matt now by accident, I think I'd still be like, oh, like, I think I'm just like trained to be embarrassed of it.
Yeah.
So even now it's like, oh, not that I'm actually embarrassed. I just almost think like, oh, like, did that, if it happens and you didn't mean for it to happen, it's a bit embarrassing.
Oh my god. Yeah. We never fart in front of one another.
Like,
we haven't crossed that in 10 years.
Hold on for a second. In 10 years.
Unless I'm really mad at Kim, and then I'll just let loose.
Oh my god. Ew.
The truth is coming. But
not often.
You know what happens? One more thing to carry on with the fart conversation. Because I never really fart in front of Matt, he will tell me if I've done it like while I've been sleeping, and then he'll chuckle about it in the morning. I'm like, thanks, Matt.
Oh.
I know, he's like, last night. I was asleep. It doesn't count.
Yeah, it does not count if you're sleeping. That's what guys, we have a spammer here. I'm going to just get him out. Everyone keeps telling me to block him, and I just, I can't, I actually, oh, okay.
report. Guys, I'm trying to get him out of here, but everyone's like, don't you have anything better to do, Jack? Like, yeah, Jack, why are you even here if you hate it? Like, why are you here? Why are you talking to us?
Watch something else, Jack.
We love life. We're happy. Yeah, you don't get... But you guys want to see the cake?
Really
look
cute.
How cute! Baskin-Robbins. And by the way, guys, stay tuned because I'm going to put out an Instagram post tomorrow and we're going to give away three $100 Baskin-Robbins gift certificates. So I will let you know like what the contest details are tomorrow, but how cute is that?
Mm, what flavor is this one?
I don't actually know, but yesterday we had one with Cassie.
I saw it with mint chocolate chip.
It was,
that's my favorite.
Oh, it was so
good. Like a cake?
It was killer.
Mint chocolate chip cake?
Yeah, I don't think I've had that flavor in an ice cream
would
cake.
Would we be eligible to win the $100?
I don't think so. We're entering. Okay. We're just going to take this one.
Yeah, I know. It's so cute. Well, we get to eat this one tonight. But Cassie, like last night we ate one with Cassie and it was mint chocolate chip. And it was like, she was just like, so like, she literally was like licking her plate.
Was it Snapchat? And
yeah.
She was just like, like her face was so excited when you guys were cutting into the ice cream cake.
Yeah, I know.
Like,
she was
so
excited.
Cute.
Guys, before I forget, okay, I have to tell you guys one thing. If you are just joining us right now, we have almost 300 people with us right now, but lots of you have been coming and going as the night has gone on. It's been so much fun. If you guys are new, this channel is Ask Kimberly, so it's a relationship channel, and we have like the best little community in the whole world. I love you guys so much. We do Q&As, and I'm going to start doing live videos more often. But number one is... make sure if you haven't already, click that little notification bell and do it right now just so that you get updates and notifications every time I actually do upload a new video because YouTube has been changing, and if you have the mobile app, like, you don't always hear when we upload a new video. Mm-hmm. So definitely go and do that right now. And definitely go and subscribe to Nikki's channel.
Health Nut Nutrition.
Yeah, Health Nut Nutrition. So her channel is so awesome. Honestly, she's like... freaking kitchen goals. Like, seriously.
Cookies.
Oh my god, let's see.
I brought some oatmeal raisin cookies.
Oh my god.
You can save one for Cassie.
I'm excited.
Literally made those like
just before
an hour ago.
Oh my god. No, she's so amazing. And like, I don't know if you guys know this, but I actually don't cook very often. And like, ask Nathan, he knows.
No, it's true. I cook very often.
Nathan cooks very often. Yeah, I think I need to learn some stuff from Nikki. And we did another video on Nikki's channel where we were making some Valentine's Day goodies, and they turned out really, really good.
Strawberry cheesecake tarts?
Yeah, strawberry cheesecake tarts.
Those
they were
so good.
So delicious. So if you guys tried it out, let us know. Oh my god, Jack, stop.
Go away, Jack.
Yeah, go away, Jack. Can everybody say, like, go away, Jack?
Go away,
Jack.
What the heck?
We don't know Jack, and we don't want to know Jack.
Aww. Oh my goodness. Okay, so does anyone here have... Because I told my most embarrassing crush story ever. So we're going to tell some embarrassing story. Well, do you guys have any embarrassing story?
I'm trying to think, because I was thinking about the one with my girlfriend who, you know, had the accidental slip up.
Yeah.
Or slip out.
Oh, no.
But I'm trying to think of, like, an embarrassing one that's, like... Can you think of one, Matt? Like, that's happened with us?
It's tough when you're on the spot trying to think of one.
I know.
One.
I'm
like,
trying to think of something.
I've got a pretty good one.
You do? Okay, I'm going
to
sit over here.
Time to think about it. Like, yours, if you want.
Love to hear one.
Yeah.
Okay. I need to, like, set my arm down. Oh. This is really heavy. Okay, there we go.
So, yeah. So, I'll tell you guys a little bit about one of my embarrassing stories. And this is just when I was starting to get to know... how to talk to girls, and whoa, that's your hand. That's
guys, oh, sorry. Yeah. Guys, this is Nathan. If you haven't met him yet, this is my hubby, Nathan.
Hello. Yeah, so this is a story about when I was really starting to learn how to talk to girls and get confident, and it was really tough. I remember one of the first girls I ever asked out, this was in grade 9, it was like, I was really nervous, I was really fiddling with my hands, and it was actually in a hockey rink. Because we're Canadian, so I guess that kind of is pretty cliche, but at my high school, and I had my hands up on the glass, and I was, like, really not confident in myself, and I asked her out, and she's like, oh, no, I've got this boyfriend in Newfoundland, or some lie like that.
She lied?
Yeah, she lied. And
what?
Yeah, she lied. But at the time, I'm like, oh, okay, yeah, that totally makes sense. Like, I get it.
And literally the next week, she started going out with another guy at my school.
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah, well.
Funny.
I only shared the good stories.
Oh, poor. Someone says, Tess Tiger Girl says, poor Nathan. Everyone says, aw.
Yeah. But look at where it all ended up. So you got it. You know, it's all about.
The big picture.
It's all failures lead to success. And that was one of my early failures. And I learned to know how. I learned how to talk to girls, and I learned how to present myself and be more confident. Yeah, this is where it ended up. So
yeah, seriously. I think I actually strongly agree with that, you guys. Because, like, we were talking about my most embarrassing crush moment, which happened when I was 6 in grade 1.
6?
Yeah, because, like, so I was telling these guys, I told these guys the whole story, but basically the gist of it is that I had this crush, his name was Robbie Reedman, and everyone's like, we hate Robbie Reedman on now, so I shouldn't have said his name, obviously, they're going to, like, go and Google him. You guys don't now Google him, seriously, I know. I don't know what happened to him. But anyways, I wrote him a, like, major love note with, like, two people kissing on the front. My parents helped me, and I was like, I love you. Will you marry me? And I gave it to him at school, and he threw it on the floor. And then the teacher picked it up and read it in front of the whole class.
Oh.
I know.
Ouch.
The worst. Yeah. The worst. Oh, seriously. God, so bad.
Embarrassing.
I know. So we're also doing another giveaway. On, like, just in the comments here. So out of all the Instagram comments and all the comments here, the most embarrassing story, you guys, is going to win a Kylie Jenner lip kit in the shade of Love Bite. So definitely tell us your embarrassing stories, because we want to hear what they are. We may not be able to read all of them right now because, the brunette is beautiful.
Aww.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Where are we?
Oh, here we go.
You guys made Nathan's day.
Yeah, exactly.
Sorry, guys. There's so many comments.
I know, it's hard.
Wild.
I can't read them from there.
I know, it's just going so fast. Everyone's talking to Jack. Everyone's, like, bashing Jack. Like, Jack, you mother ever, go away.
I saw some pretty funny comments there.
It's so awesome. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody. If you're just joining us for the first time, I'm Ask Kimberly, and this is my hubby Nathan. This is my friend Nikki of Health Nut Nutrition.
Hello.
And this is her boyfriend Matt. These two were in my recent video, the outfit video for Valentine's Day with Honey. This is a channel all about relationships, and we are celebrating Valentine's Day today. We have some cake, we have some snacks, we have some fun, we have some mortifying moments. And so if you are not subscribed, you should subscribe, because I do videos every single week, twice a week, on relationships, and yeah, I just love talking about relationships, and I love you guys. So, who has an embarrassing moment? Do you have one, Nikki?
Well, I was trying to think of one. I was trying to think of one that was, like, embarrassing when I was younger. Like, I mean, I have, like, kind of an embarrassing scenario for Matt when we were dating, because when we started.
For Matt.
Well, I mean, I don't know if it's, like, as, like, embarrassing as ones you guys mentioned, but basically when we started dating, so I met Matt through, Matt and I have been together, like, what, almost.
Nine years?
Almost, yeah, June will be 9 years. And, which is crazy long. And I actually met Matt through my older sister. And so when we started hanging out, I think once we hadn't made it official or anything, but it was, like, apparent that we liked each other, and we were hanging out a lot. And then, so none of my sister didn't know that we were, like, kind of seeing each other, and none of, because I was hanging out with my, like, sister's friends. You know when you, like, start reaching that age where I think I, like, hit 19, and then I started, like, going out drinking with my sister and having that relationship with her. So we would all be going out and stuff, and I remember, like, none of my sister's friends knew that, like, we were kind of a thing. So they would be like, there's so many different scenarios where, like, one would be, I remember we were all out on a patio in Toronto, and, like, you know, my sister's guy friends, who I've grown up with, you know, so they're good friends with me too, but, like, I remember they'd be like, hey Matt, like, check out that hot girl there or whatever, and, like, they would, like, but they didn't even know, they weren't doing it on purpose, thinking, like, oh, maybe he's into Nikki. They're actually like, oh, like, check her out, or whatever. And Matt was just like, yeah, I saw it. And he's just like, like, just things like, it was actually really funny. And I'd be like, don't worry about it. But, like, Matt had to, like, seem, like, into it. Because I was like, I don't want my sister to know we're kind of dating yet. Because it's just, like, that weird, like, And then I remember one time, like, we were over at Matt's place, like, we were having kind of, like, a house party, and I think, like, one of his friends, this is awful, was, like, messaging, like, some girl Matt knew, like, on, like, what was it, MSN chat? I don't know. Do you guys know what MSN was?
Yeah. ICQ. Does anyone?
And I think it was just, like, this girl, and he's messaging, and I guess she liked Matt and stuff, and, like, he's just, like, telling Matt, me and Matt were, like, just chilling on, sitting on his bed, and, like, he's telling everything that this girl's saying, thinking it's Matt, and Matt is just, like, mortified, like, the whole time, just, like, apologizing, like, I'm so sorry.
Oh.
So that's what happens when you keep things, like relationships
secret.
A secret.
I know, you have to come out and tell everybody, but it's hard sometimes, right, when you don't want the world to, like, be in your business.
I know, and you're like, oh, and then poor Matt had to, like, defend himself, like, I swear I'm not a brat.
Oh no. Oh my god.
Matt, do you have like any like embarrassing from like when you were younger? Because I'm trying to think.
Embarrassing dating stories?
Yeah, I'm trying to think of like more embarrassing dating. Dating stories that I've had. Oh, everybody, oh my god, you guys are just going on and on about Jack. So, where did Nikki get her choker from?
I got it actually at Urban Outfitters.
Oh, Urban Outfitters. Yeah, it's really cute. I like it a lot too. Yeah, somebody was asking.
Are they still talking about
Jack? Somebody says the way Nathan's looking at her is goals. You guys are so cute.
Oh.
I love ya.
I've got another one if you want. I don't know.
I have a lot of embarrassing moments too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you guys, okay, do you want to go first or should I go first?
You can go first because I already, right?
Yes.
And ladies first.
Okay, but this one isn't a crush one. This is just like a random embarrassing thing that happened to me. Because like, I don't know if you guys know this about me yet, but like.
Is it the Scotland story?
No, it's not. Okay. You can tell it was so embarrassing.
I love that one.
I have so many embarrassing moments, you guys. It's crazy. I don't know what it is about me, but I just end up in embarrassing situations.
I don't have these like super embarrassing moments.
Yeah.
But it's actually crazy because. But it's crazy because I feel like, because I don't know what it is about me, but like I just don't embarrass anymore because I just do crazy things all the time.
You've
and get embarrassed and like now everyone just knows everything about me. But no, this story happened when I was in a play in high school. I was in a play called Oliver with my brother Mitch. We were in this play together and I had to wear a mic. And I remember I had my mic, like it was like on my shirt, and I went off stage and then I had to go to the bathroom. And so I went, but like, I guess someone left my mic on by accident, like the person that was doing the sound. And so like the whole audience heard me go to the bathroom.
No.
And I was like singing in the bathroom step two.
Wait a minute.
That's like
wait
something you see in a movie.
Did you have like jalapeno poppers the night before?
No, I didn't.
Oh my.
Yeah, that is so bad. I know. It was bad. I was
that's
so. I know, right? Everyone's saying, "Oh
yeah,
no!"
That's a scene out of a movie. Yeah.
I know. And then people like it was a matinee too. So like I was talking, I was like talking to people after, and they were like, "Was that you?" Because it was like people that I knew were like in the audience and like heard that, and they knew it was me because of my singing. Because I was like, "Da da da da!" Like,
oh my! You can't even just like play it off. It's like,
nope.
No, wasn't me? You know.
So embarrassing.
So what's
so
the Scotland story? Or were you gonna tell a different one?
I don't know. It depends. We can go a couple different directions, right? Like,
I'm really enjoying this.
Yeah.
Scotland's
not really a relationship, though, right? I can
that's
still
okay.
Tell it,
do you guys? Okay, so here's the deal. Do you guys want to hear my most embarrassing moment ever? Like my most embarrassing moment ever.
It's pretty good.
Do you know
though. I mean, it was just me that was there, so.
Sure.
I feel like I know so many other people have super embarrassing moments. And I'm like...
So
and
am I going to tell this story or what?
Yes, I think you should.
Is this the most
people are saying yes, yes.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and say it's pretty embarrassing, but I was the only one that was there to witness it, so it's not that bad because it... And I mean, I'm still here. So we were in Scotland and we were on vacation. It was amazing. We were there for, what was it, like our third anniversary? No. Second anniversary.
Yeah, it was like an anniversary trip that we were taking.
Second wedding anniversary trip. And lots of fun. She convinces me to go to the spa. And, you know, like some guys, not all, because some guys love spas, I was like, what do you even do there? And she's describing it to me. She's like, this is it's the best thing ever. You go into a hot area, and then you go into a cold area, and then you go into a hot area again. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh yeah, that's awesome. Intense, right?
So anyways, Nathan doesn't like spas, but I love the spas.
I hate them. I'm not a non-fan. I'm just, you know, it's not my number one thing. Anyways, so we're there and we go into the hot area first and it's like boiling. It's like a sauna, which, you know, I've done a sauna before, I like that. And then we go to the cold area, which here, there wasn't like a cold room like Kim was used to. Instead, there was this like area where there was all this ice, right? So there's this ice bucket on the ground and Kim starts grabbing all of the ice and she's so hot.
I was so hot. Like, I started putting it all over my face. Yeah,
she's like, oh my God. She's like, oh, this is great. Oh, I'm just like, this is the best thing ever, right? And I'm like, I'm no expert, but I don't think that that's the right ice. And I point at it. I'm like, I don't think that's the right ice. And she's like, what do you mean? I'm like, well, isn't that, there's like a unit on the wall that looks like kind of ice where it comes out of your fridge, right? And if that was the ice dispensing unit. I'm pretty sure that's where the clean ice is coming from. Oh my God. That's like the dirty, like, foot ice. And she's like, ah! Because the best part was, she's going like this. She's like rubbing it in. She's basically, she's like licking your lips. She's like, oh, this is amazing. And I'm like,
that salty goodness.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure like some guy with like athlete's foot might have been like rubbing his, you know, his corns and then putting them in the ice bucket. And anyways, it was amazing. You had to be there. I was like,
oh my God, you guys, the comments are freaking cracking me up right now. They're so you guys are.
It was great. Oh my God. It was great because you were the spa expert. And I was the spa novice.
Foot ice all
and
over
you were the
face.
One that dunked your head into the ice.
Okay, I thought you were
going
to say though it was the pee bucket.
No,
that would have been worse.
Oh,
that would have been worse.
No, no, I don't think there's a pee bucket. Why would there be a pee bucket
in a spa?
I don't know. I don't know. We were like,
we go to different spas. Like, there's no pee bucket.
People are asking for Matt. We want you to. People want Matt to tell a story.
Oh no.
Should I come around?
No, I.
You guys want to hear Matt tell a story?
No, just stay there. We're good.
As a foot face. Yeah, it was foot face.
Foot face.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
Oh my God, everyone's saying, yay, Matt.
Okay. So when I was younger, I was probably 14. I was a really big nerd, like glasses, braces, long hair. And I was up at my friend's cottage in the summertime. And it was a girl I had a crush on. And I thought I would look cooler by taking my glasses off. And we were playing hide and go seek, like a tag game at night. But I wanted to look cool for the girl, right? So I took my glasses off. I don't have good eyesight. So obviously dark and no glasses means I can't see. And we're playing this game and I'm like running full tilt. You know, I think we're trying to hide or whatever. And there's a fence, like a chainmail fence with a metal pole right
there. I know where this is going.
I just ran smack dab into this pole, like running full tilt, and just boom, hit this pole. I bust two teeth inwards, blood's everywhere.
Oh my God.
Had to go to the hospital, like rip my lip
wide
open.
And that was in front of your crush?
Yeah, so needless to say, I probably would have looked cooler keeping the glasses on, I think, at that point.
Did you get a second date?
Oh my God.
It was my first kiss. That was a girl
You kissed her after that?
Not then, afterwards.
Okay, so it didn't ruin anything.
No, but it was the next summer, and at that summer, I'd like lost my, I got contacts and had my braces off, so I was a bit.
Oh, you're feeling better about yourself then.
So Matt, yeah, like over, what's the story? Like over a summer, you like got contacts and you got your braces off and then like you went from like nerd to like the hot boy that everybody wanted at school.
Yeah, kind of. That was a huge nerd.
And now he's mine.
I feel like everybody can have a transformation at some point.
Yeah.
I feel like I had that too. Like I had glasses and braces. I even had headgear when I was growing up.
So
like,
did
for,
I.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. But like, hey, it's worth it because like then you don't have to worry about your teeth like for the rest of your life.
But at the time,
right?
You don't think that. You're not like,
God,
oh, this will be so worth it.
You have
at the
like
time,
the most
like
perfect teeth.
Oh
like people
God.
Are always commenting on your teeth.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's. Yeah. It's crazy. I think it is so worth it, but it's like so hard when you're going through that in like grade 11 or whatever.
It was awful.
Okay. So you guys are asking me for Oh, Jack is gone. Yeah, yay. So exciting. You guys are saying that you want to do a bit of a Q&A. We have been live for over an hour now for 64 minutes, and I really want you guys to stay involved in the conversation. So I think you guys stopped Jack. Yay! So maybe I'm gonna take you guys like to my little Valentine's Day table, and I'm gonna just answer a couple of your questions, like your questions, and then maybe we'll come back to the guys. Do you want to come with me, Nikki? And we can do it together.
Maybe the boys can cut the cake.
Yeah, you guys can get the cake and stuff ready, and we'll just, because I really want to chat with you guys.
Do you want to start eating the cake?
Yeah, sure. We can eat the cake for sure. So this is my little Valentine's table. My flowers. Those are the flowers Nathan got me.
Aww.
And little cards and candies and stuff like that. But basically, if you guys are new here, this channel is Ask Kimberly. I'm Kimberly, and this is my friend Nikki.
Hi,
she has a YouTube channel called Health Nut Nutrition, and we're just like hanging out tonight. Like after this live stream, we're probably just gonna like, you know, have some food and hang out a little bit longer and stuff. And we did a video together for Valentine's Day that was like an outfit idea video. And you guys loved it so much. It was
so much fun filming it. Like,
yeah, it was so fun.
It was
fun.
Just very different from, because I'm usually in the kitchen because I do healthy recipes and lifestyle stuff on my channel, but I don't really get to do that lookbook style things, going to different venues and stuff. And I felt like I was like acting for the different scenarios. And
stuff. It was so fun. Like, we always have fun shooting, but like,
It was a little cold in the dresses, but we made it work.
We did. We did. And we're like friends too. I think that's the fun thing is that like a lot of time when you film on YouTube, it's like just you, you know, and it's like your own thing. But it's nice when you have other friends that are like in the same, doing the same kind of thing. So it's like so much more fun when we can
do
it together.
It doesn't feel like work. We were just kind of like feeding off of each other and just having fun with it. And like, I think at the end that made a really good video because it was
definitely
more natural. And it's like, yeah, we're actually friends in real life, not just on YouTube.
Yeah, definitely. It was so fun. So I'm going to take a couple of your relationship questions now, and maybe Nikki can, we can answer too. Like, can you guys see us okay? Because I want to make sure that, like,
we'll get code
my arms are getting so sore right now because I've been holding the phone for like 70 minutes. If you guys are new, this is Ask Kimberly, like I said. We are celebrating Valentine's Day today, and we've got Nikki over, we've got the guys here. It's such a fun day. It's like my Christmas, so like it's a really big deal, Valentine's Day, for me. I've been so busy this week. But yeah, like if you have not already, guys, make sure you are subscribed to this channel, Ask Kimberly, and subscribe to Nikki's channel, Health Nut Nutrition, and click that little notification bell so that you actually get notified. Mm-hmm. I am going to start doing live videos like way more often, and this is kind of like a test, but it's been really fun, and I think I'm going to be doing this a lot more. So definitely, guys, click that notification bell so that you know when we're actually going live, okay?
Is that cookie dough?
Okay, so Shelly Jelly says, we're going to start the Q&A right now. Shelly Jelly says, how do you ask a guy out? That was like literally the first question I saw. Okay, my own opinion is that if that's something that you want to do, you should be totally empowered to do it. It's not something that should be super intimidating or scary, although it can definitely feel that way. The more experience that you get with actually talking to your crush, so whether that's a guy or a girl, the better it's going to get for you, the easier it's going to get. And let's face it, like in my experience, I feel like people have to deal with a lot of rejection in their lives in order to actually get good at approaching people, right? Like it doesn't just, some people just do it naturally and it's amazing and it's all well and good, but like the majority of people have to practice.
Scared of getting like rejected, right? So it's always, but I always think like, I think everything happens for a reason. And I think like, okay, if maybe someone's your crush or you're just, you know, in that infatuation phase and you know what, you tell them how you feel and they kind of decline you, well, like it's probably not who you're meant to be with.
Yeah,
or it probably wouldn't have worked out anyways.
Definitely.
I always think like what I would do, and kind of what I did with, I guess, what Matt and I did, like we kept things very like casual in the beginning, and like, you know, I think Matt was more so like, hey, you want to just hang out? It wasn't like, do you want to go on a date? It was just like, hey, like, do you want to go hang out as friends? Like,
yeah,
it was just super casual, and then you can see if like you even like kind of work together.
Yeah, because like part of a date is you evaluating the other person, right? It's not all about being like, oh, can I make them like me? It's about being like, oh, can I can I see if this person is actually a match for me? So I think that's really important in any relationship and with any crush. So yeah, if you guys are just joining us, we are just starting the Q&A portion of the evening. I'm Kimberly and this is Nikki and this channel is Ask Kimberly. I honestly think too, when asking a guy out, you can start really small. So if you're in the same group of friends and say you're on a group date, because like I know a lot of group dating happens kind of like in middle school and early high school. That's definitely something that I did. Was group dates, and one of the best things to do with your crush is actually just take them aside and try to get them alone. So be like, oh, do you want to grab an ice cream? Like, while everyone else is like getting movie tickets or whatever. So yeah. Kind of like taking them aside and getting the opportunity to just talk to them one-on-one, because that's the first step to actually, so it's kind of like a mini date, right? It's not really like a date where it's like, oh, will you go for dinner and a movie with me on Friday night? But grabbing ice cream or like, you know, even if you're at school and you want to go grab a slice of pizza for lunch or something, but it's just the two of you, like that kind of counts as like time alone with them. So I really feel like that's the first step in kind of seeing if you like someone.
Yeah, and with the lunch thing, I think it's not putting yourself out there if you're just like, hey, you want to go grab lunch? It's almost like you're not making it seem like a very intimate thing. You're just like, want to go grab lunch? And if anything, they'll probably be like, yeah, sure, that's fine. But if you're like, want to go to the movies on a date, it might seem more like,
yeah, like intense, super formal. Yeah. And if the person doesn't know you at all, it can actually be a little bit intimidating and scary and like maybe even a little bit, I don't want to say a turn off, but because I think it's still good to put yourself out there, but it's nice to ease into it and kind of make them feel like you're not being like, oh, will you be my forever boyfriend kind of thing, right? Okay, do you guys have any other questions? Hopefully that helps. Pickles.
And if all else fails, just offer Leafs tickets.
Oh.
Leafs tickets?
Is that what happened?
That we've been discussing it.
What are you guys talking about?
We would go to a Leafs game.
Oh, you guys were saying what for you a guys
date.
Would do.
Yeah. Oh yeah. We'd go for a date.
Something that a guy that he would really want to do, right?
Yeah. Oh, but not everybody here knows like watches hockey.
What about like an action movie?
Yeah, offer action movie tickets. Oh, I'm gonna start eating some ice cream. By the way, don't mind me while I pig out on ice cream.
I know this is actually, I was telling you earlier, mint chocolate chip is one of my favorite ice creams. Well. Chocolate chip cookie dough.
Oh, is it cookie dough? Oh my god,
it's so good. My second favorite.
Okay, I'm just looking at some of the questions. They're going really fast, you guys.
How can you tell if someone likes you?
How do I know I like someone?
What about shy guys? Maybe we should, is there a way to like slow them down?
No, there isn't. Can you hold them? Guys are bringing it. Like you can scroll back like this. My crush shows mixed emotions. A lot, just so you guys know, if I read out a comment and we're not going to answer it, it's only because I have a lot of videos that are already on some of these things and I will direct you guys. Oh shoot, where are the questions going? This is crazy, you guys. 282 of you are on right now, but like it's been so many of you through the course of the night. Okay, a lot of you right now are asking about mixed signals. Does anyone here want to hear about mixed signals and like what to do if someone's giving you mixed signals? Like, can you say yes or no? Tell us if you want to hear a little bit about that. Yes? No. Well, no.
Sure,
yes, sure. Yes, please. Yes. Okay, so there's enough yeses, I think. Guys, this has to be fair. Like, Ask Kimberly is all about fairness and equality, and we want to make sure that if you guys want to hear about something, that I'm actually going to talk about those things. So that's what this is all about. So a lot of people ask me about mixed signals. So people will say, okay, this guy I like 1 second, it's like he likes me and he's doing all of the things that show me that he's interested. And then the next minute he's totally cold. Like it's like he forgot I existed or he just fell off the face of the planet. Has this ever happened to you guys? Let us know. Yes.
I feel like that's even happened to me.
Doesn't notice me. Yeah, that's happened to me as well, right?
And like elementary, it's like, you know, you think a boy's into you and stuff, and then you're like, you know, you try to like make more of a move, and they just like, it's like nothing.
Mm-hmm.
I remember I told a guy that I liked him in elementary, and it was like, I thought, you know, he might like me too, and it was just like, I didn't kind of get a response back, and I like literally broke my heart, because it was like, oh, like, I'm just like, but I got like such mixed signals, I think, that I was really confused, and like now looking back, like, I don't think it would have worked or, you know, now I'm like, oh, okay. You know, it's just like, it was just a fling,
But it's hard when you're like, you really like someone and you, and they're sometimes, you know, they're just being nice back, and you can confuse that as, oh, he or she likes me.
Yeah, definitely. But sometimes people, like, even if they do like you, like, they give you all of those signals, and then, and then they just, it's like they're actually having trouble deciding as well.
Like a commitment issue or something.
Yeah, like either there's a commitment issue or like they don't actually know if they like you, which is, it can be so confusing. And so, and sometimes like it could also show that the person is only in it for some, like a certain reason, right? So mm-hmm. It might be like if you're at a party and there's a kiss and they try to take it further and it's like, oh, this guy really likes me. But then like the weekend is over and the next Monday at school, you go to school and, you know, you get totally ignored. Or you want a date and someone's like, oh, I'm totally gonna text you again, and then the next day comes, a week goes by, and they never do. So that I feel is mixed signals, and a lot of people get them. So my honest opinion is that if you do get mixed signals, the person doesn't like you. What do you think?
Sorry, choked on ice cream. I always say that, like, if a guy or girl likes you and you're kind of having that back and forth thing, it's like, if you're waiting for that the other person to call and they don't call, like, if they like you and they're that interested, they will call. Like, I think people get really hung up on, like, they're, like, waiting by the phone for that person to, like, message or call them. And I'm like, trust me. Like, even, like, for, you know, coming from a girl's experience, like, I just know I have a lot of guy friends. Even talking with, you know, my boyfriend Matt, you know, he agrees too, like, if a guy is interested, like, he will call. What's that mm-hmm. movie that's like, he's just mm-hmm. not that
he's
into
just not
you?
That into you.
Like, yeah. That is so true, though. Like, mm-hmm. if he's interested, he will call. Because,
I agree.
Like, no one, even if they lose your number, like, there's, like, Facebook now. You can look up people. You can figure out who, like, I don't know, how to get a hold of them.
Yeah.
So
that's been my opinion, too. I mean, obviously, like, if with my work as well. It's like, if someone is into you, whether it's a guy or a girl, they will literally go to hell and high water to make contact with you if mm-hmm. they like you. So if they're showing, if they're kind of flip-flopping back and forth, my opinion on it is that it's almost like that they're not even worth your time to pursue, because they are going to cause you so much more heartache in the end if they're not showing signs of, like, commitment right off the bat.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Sorry, guys, I'm just looking at some more of the questions. Good point. How do you know if you've been friend-zoned? That's a good one.
Oh, I have an interesting... happened recently, actually.
Oh, no. Do you guys want to hear about being friend-zoned? Let's hear...
It's kind of... It has to do with, like, friend... I mean, you can go first, and then I can give my experience, because I actually had an issue recently with, you know, that whole, like, can girls and guys be friends?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh no.
But I can tell that after.
Okay, I'm getting like a mix of yes and no's. Yes, 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 yes. Okay. Yes, thank you so much. Yes, yes. Okay. So there's enough yeses here, and guys, don't worry. We will go on, like, we will still talk about other things after this. This is not like the last thing that we're going to talk about, but for a quick minute we will talk about getting friend zone. Tell us. Oh, you guys are so sweet. Okay. Yeah, so what's your story about being friend zoned?
So, and hopefully he's not watching.
I'm like totally taking on ice cream, by the way. Oh, so happy Valentine's Day!
Woo! Cheers!
It's Galentine's Day. Guys, if you're just joining us, welcome, by the way. This is Ask Kimberly. I'm Ask Kimberly. This is Nikki from HealthNet Nutrition.
Hi, guys.
Subscribe to our channels and make sure you click that notification bell. And yeah, we are chatting all about relationships tonight. Woo!
So, we're talking about kind of like friend zones, and I'm going to just tell a story about I'll just start from the beginning. So this guy I went to school with, I went to college with, great friends. Like, we always hung out, we always studied together. You know, we'd like go out and party together. And then this was like, I've known him now for, I'd say five or six years. And I've always suspected a little bit of, like, you know when someone's, like, gets a little, like, is a close talker?
Yes.
But I didn't want to be the one to be, like, I hope you don't think this is more than it is.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, he, like
they just hug you a little bit too long.
Yeah, and they're just, close. And, like, the whole time I was in school, I've been with Matt, because Matt and I have been together for, like, 9 years. So, like, he knew I was with someone, and it was never, like, nothing ever happened for me to actually make a point of saying, like, oh, you know, I'm not into you like that. And like I said, we used to go out and party all the time together, but, like, as a group. Like, Matt would be there. We had tons of house parties in Toronto while I was in school, and it was always, like, nothing weird happened. Then... I'd say last summer.
Last summer?
No, wait, sorry. Last, what is it now? 2000 and, okay, so say like about a year ago, we'll say.
Okay.
We were out at a club and Matt wasn't there. And I think Matt was in Alberta at this time. And
I know where this is going.
And we... I think he had a few too many drinks and stuff. And so anyways, I think he like had a couple too many drinks and he hadn't seen me in a while and stuff. And like everyone's like dancing and stuff. And he kept kind of getting a little bit close.
Oh my gosh.
And then to the point that he was like close talking me and it was kind of getting awkward. And I was kind of getting mad because I'm thinking like, he knows I'm with Matt. Like I'm kind of offended right now that he's getting this close and it was getting awkward.
That's pushing the limits for sure.
And I think at one point he actually tried to like, kiss me on my but on the side or something. I don't know, but then I was like mad and it got really awkward and then we were leaving anyways and we're all leaving and then like it was one of those things if he didn't bring it up I would have been actually really annoyed. And then we're about to so my sister was the DD and so we got to the car and so my friend and my sister go inside the car because they know, like, something's going to happen. And then basically, like, my guy friend, like, confesses, like, his love for me outside. It was... I did not...
That's so... And you're in a relationship and you fully knew it.
And it was really hard because it was like, you know, I care about this person. He's a super sweet guy and he means well. Like, he wasn't doing it to be, like a jerk or, like, to get me to, like, cheat on Matt or something. It was really just, like... He had to get it off his chest. And okay. I respect that. But at the same time, too, like, I had to. I hear Matt in the background.
Oh, my God.
So I wanted to be nice about it and kind of just say, you know, like it was full on, like, I've always liked you. I think about if, like, things were different. And, but to be honest, like, he's such, like, an adventure-seeking person.
Yeah.
Like, so is Matt. But, like, that's, like, his full-time job is, like... all the stuff and like I'm like a mix like I'll go outside my comfort zone a bit but I'm thinking like I'm not the girl for you and the worst thing is he's with someone and still with that girl.
What?
So what I felt really bad about was the girl.
Oh my god, what the heck?
I felt bad because I'm like I would hate to be that girl on the other side knowing it'd be like if you know Nathan or Matt was confessing their love to another girl and settling for
us. Yeah, like,
us.
What the heck? That's so inappropriate.
Like, I wouldn't want to be someone's plan B.
No, definitely not.
But it was bad. I had to, like, let him down. And, like, and we didn't talk for quite a while. Like, we talk now and like, but I wouldn't say we used to go out for dinner, just the two of us, or for a movie or rock climbing. But, like, now I feel like it's crossed that path where I would feel like I was doing something wrong, too.
Yeah, totally.
But it was...
Now that you know, now that you have that
info. Can you imagine someone literally, like, it was intense.
That is intense. Honestly, you guys, we've talked about this on my channel before, but my honest opinion is if you have a crush and your crush is in a relationship, let them be in their relationship. Like, have respect. I have respect for relationships in general because, like, I love relationships. And if someone's happy in their relationship, you don't want to mess that up for them, you know? And if they have troubles and, like, they break up, hey, then maybe you can tell them how you feel, but... If they're happy, like, your role should be to kind of support them as their friend and just support their relationships because that's what a good friend does. Okay, and you guys want to hear a little bit about friend zone stuff? I have a video, actually. It's called, like, 8 Ways to Get Out of the Friend Zone because a lot of you guys get stuck in that friend zone, which is a little bit... it can be really tough and frustrating when you're in that situation. We love you. Thank you for doing this. Oh, you guys are so sweet. I love you guys so much. Thank you for coming. If you guys are new, welcome to the family. This channel is Ask Kimberly. It's all about relationships. I'm Kimberly, and this is Nikki, my friend of Health Nut Nutrition. And make sure you guys are subscribed. Make sure you hit that little notification bell. We are hanging out. It's Valentine's Day. We have our Baskin Robbins cake. We're giving away 1 Kylie Jenner lip kit and 3 $100 Baskin Robbins gift certificates tonight for the most embarrassing story, most embarrassing crush story. We've been hearing them all night and we are continuing to get some in the comments. So guys, keep leaving comments and
keep
we will go
coming.
Through all of them and decide who is the most embarrassing. It's going to be wild. I'm sure we've heard some really, really embarrassing ones already. Oh, favorite channel by far. You guys are so sweet. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for coming. We've been live streaming for almost an hour and a half. I can't even believe this. I've never even done a live stream other than on Instagram. Like, do you guys want to see more live streams on this channel? Because I feel like, I was saying this earlier tonight, like, I think it'd be so nice because we do Q&As every week.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, there's thousands of questions. I literally only get to answer 10 or 15, and it's so hard to choose. So if you guys want, aw, you guys are so sweet. Yes, 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 yes.
I know, there's something so great about live streaming. It's like you really get that connection, like, instantly. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I can't, like, honestly, like, I'm just going to go on a little, like, I love you guys so much. I can't even tell you how much I appreciate all of you and, like, how much I love our relationship. And I was saying this earlier that, like, I just feel like we have something so special on YouTube because of the types of things that we talk about and how much you guys are all so supportive of each other in the comments. Like, we talk about relationships, and then you guys all give each other advice, and you all participate on Snapchat. Like, we have something so special, and, like, I just feel so blessed to be able to have you guys as subscribers and hang out with you from time to time. So I'll definitely do this more often, but let me know if that's what you guys really want. Okay, so we have time for a couple more questions. So I'm just looking now. So if you have questions, ask multiple crushes. Ask Kimberly family. Love you guys. Shout out to my girlfriend, Bria. Hi to your crush. How to deal with an ex you see every day? Oh, that's a good question. So many. Okay, how to ask a guy out. We just talked about that one. Soldier Boy, please give me a shout out. Hey, Soldier Boy. Hi. Hi. My Snapchat is Kimberly Moffitt. Oh, I love you guys so much. Oh, my gosh. How to deal with awkward eye contact.
I know, they go so fast.
Dating in high school. Do I like kittens? Of course I like kittens. Of course. I love you, Sierra. Oh my goodness. Multiple crushes. Okay. Do you guys want to hear about having multiple crushes? I'm seeing that quite a bit. Okay, I'm seeing some questions about who are we. Guys, my name is Kimberly. This channel is Ask Kimberly. Welcome. It's a relationship channel. This is Nikki, my friend.
Hi, guys.
From Health Nut Nutrition. She does, like, amazing food videos. It's all super healthy stuff, but, like, really delicious and, like, aww, super yummy. You. So you guys should definitely go subscribe to her as well. Multiple crushes. Yes, no, no, no. No. Okay, lots of no's.
I think maybe it was just one person asking.
One. Oh, okay. Okay. Is a bad boy a good boyfriend? No. Mm-mm. No. No. Funny Valentine's Day stories. Oh my god, I have a funny Valentine's Day story.
Do you?
Yes, I do. I have a funny Valentine's Day story. Asma! Oh my gosh! Hi, how are you? I'm sorry, guys. I'm really close because I'm, like, looking at the questions.
I know, we're like,
I love you guys too. Oh, you guys want to hear it? Okay. It's really quick. I went on a date on Valentine's Day once when I was in university. I was in my master's and I went on a date with this guy and he was cute, but I didn't really like him that much. I was just like, whatever, it's Valentine's Day, I'll go on a date. And this guy, like, I don't know what he was expecting, but he invited me over to his house and I was like, okay, whatever. He said he was going to make me dinner. And he went to the grocery store, bought all these groceries, and he was like, oh, I don't know how to cook salmon. I thought you would do it for me. I was like, what? My head exploded. My head actually exploded. I was like, what? Really? Yeah, I know. What? No. I was like, really? Yeah, I was like, I don't even know, like, so we proceeded to Google it, because I didn't know how to cook salmon either, because obviously, like, I don't really cook, but he just expected, because, like, I was a girl, I would know how to make him dinner.
Oh, you must know how to do laundry, too, and clean up, and, like.
Yeah, I was like, this, yeah, I never pursued that relationship, because I just felt like it was not a good match, obviously. Yeah, that's not okay, obviously.
He wanted to date, like, his mom, who's going to make his, like, dinner and fold his clothes and
it's the 2000s, like, now it's 2017, but back then it was, like, you know, not quite, but I was even then I was like, no way, because, like, I'm super career oriented and I'm super business oriented and I'm not the kind of person, and I don't think any girl should have to be that kind of person if that's not what they want to do, right?
Yeah.
Ugh, awful. I know. Crushes and insecurities. And shy guys. Okay. Okay, can you guys tell me, would you rather hear about insecurities, like body image and crushes and that kind of thing, or shy guys? Let's get a vote. Oh, you guys are so sweet. Thank you for all the compliments. Shy guys.
Shy guys.
Oh my gosh. Okay, okay. Obviously, it has been spoken that we are going to talk about shy guys for a quick minute. And maybe we'll get to insecurities at some point, but obviously shy guys is first. It has to be first. Okay, you guys want to know how to tell if a shy guy likes you? Is that the deal? Because shy guys actually have a different way of showing that they like you than the average guy. Shy guys are very interesting. I've done a lot of videos on them. They're complex. Does anyone here have a crush on a shy guy? Is it complicated? Yes.
Especially if you're the opposite, I bet it's shy guy, really shy hard. Guy. You know what I mean? If you're like the complete opposite and you're not shy at all and you're like, you just want to like shake them and be like, you know,
yeah.
Do you like me? What's going on?
Yeah. Well, even if you're shy too, because if you're shy and they're shy, it's like, how do you even start a conversation with them, right?
Yeah.
It's really tough. The first thing, if a shy guy likes you, he's still going to look at you. Or I mean, even if a shy girl likes you, she's still going to look at you. So that's like the first step. Because we, like human beings, from a psychological perspective, we look at the people we like. We look at the things and objects that we like. I see lots of likes coming in. If I see a picture of someone that I find more attractive than, like, there are pictures of two people and I find one of them more attractive, I'm just naturally going to look at that thing more. That's like a fact. So if a shy guy likes you, he's still going to be looking at you and you're going to catch him like mid-glance looking at you. And he may be shy, he might look away, but that's kind of the first tip to knowing if he actually likes you.
Mm-hmm.
But my, like, kind of the way that I have kind of figured this out, and, like, one of the things I always talk about is, hi, Cora, you're back, great, the comments of, oh my god, Victoria's here, hi, Victoria, how are you? She won the 200,000 subscriber giveaway, she's a lucky gal, she's a really, really lucky girl, she's awesome. So I think with shy guys, the key is, like, tapping into some of their interests and hobbies, so, like, they may not necessarily play sports or do some of the things that you do, but everybody has interests and hobbies.
Yeah.
Their interests and hobbies might be different. Like maybe it's video games, right? But they still are probably really interesting people. Actually, sometimes shy people are even more interesting.
Yeah, they're more like, I don't want to say like all introverts are shy because that's not the case, but a lot of times, yeah, it's more complex. They might have they're probably maybe thinking more romantic thoughts maybe than someone that's just like, hey, I like you, you know?
Exactly. Like, so they may even have, like, more intense and passionate feelings than someone who's, like, kind of wears their heart on their sleeve.
Yeah.
So who's more extroverted. So actually, I believe that being in a relationship with a shy person can be super satisfying and, like, a really amazing relationship. It's just about, like, the hardest part in that relationship is actually getting it to happen in the first place, right? Because, like...
Yeah, and I find, like, usually if someone's shy in the beginning, it's one of those things, like, once you get to know them and stuff, they probably, like, can't stop talking or, like, it's once they're in that comfort zone,
yeah,
they're probably not as shy anymore, but they're probably shy, like, in the beginning.
Yeah. So, and that's exactly it. It's, like, I think it's just about breaking that initial barrier.
Yeah.
And so that's why I was kind of talking about interests and hobbies, and I think that's a really important thing when dealing with a shy person is, like... Sometimes it's best with them to just start out as friends, like to just kind of strike up a friend relationship and almost look at them as somebody who kind of needs the extra interaction. So treat them as if you would treat like a new person in school, like go up to them and like, I know it might seem awkward, but they're shy. Like you have to remember they're shy. Like they're not going to do it with you. Like, so you almost have to be like, oh, hey, how's it going? Like don't put pressure on yourself. Just treat them as if they're just a shy person that's new to the school. And like, you're treating them really nicely and you're showing them around, you're being a good person. Like you can just treat it like that. And then it doesn't cause you any kind of stress, but it definitely gets the ball rolling in terms of just like getting to know each other.
I agree.
I mean, you can definitely do the secret admirer thing or whatever, but like, or I mean, another thing with shy people is to start up a conversation on social media. I feel like that wasn't around when I was a kid or a teen, but that's another amazing way to actually like talk to someone, but you're not having to do it like face to face, right? Like you can talk on Twitter or you can talk on Instagram.
Well, for me, it was a lot on like the MSN. I ICQ, was it ICQ?
ICQ.
ICQ. It was like, you know, if you like someone, you would talk a lot there and be like, hey, you want to come over and hang out? And it would be like, you know, you'd be like waiting for them to message you back.
Yeah, exactly. Oh my gosh. I did that so much when I was young as well.
And like, like your heart would just drop when they would message you back. You're like, ah!
So
like,
excited. Yeah. And now like you guys, I mean, there's like text messages and email and like every, like Facebook. And what do you guys use? Like obviously Snapchat. Snapchat's probably the biggest one, I'm guessing, right? But like, with Shy Guys, if you guys follow each other on Snapchat, you're going to know they like you because they watch every single one of your stories.
That's
like,
a
they
good
never
point too.
Miss a story.
No, I know. I have a girl, like, couple girlfriends, you know, who are doing the dating right now, and it's, like, a lot of times they'll tell me, like, you know, like, they may have gone on a date with someone, they're like, well, they're still watching my Snapchat, so they're still interested.
Definitely. Like, that is actually, like, I feel like that's, like, the biggest indicator of, like, someone's interested in you is, like, how many of your Snapchats do they watch? How many of your stories do they watch? Drop your Snapchat. Oh, my Snapchat's Kimberly Moffitt. What's yours, Nikki?
You're HealthNut. So you are, and then HealthNut.
Awesome. Guys, thank you so much for joining us tonight. I love you guys all so much. If you are just tuning in, we've been on for 95 minutes. It's crazy. We're going to have to end this.
Oh, wow. There's like an actual, counter there.
Yeah, it's wild. 260 of you are on right now, but like we've been, I love you guys. Oh, this is Nikki, and her YouTube is Health Nut Nutrition. We did a video for Valentine's Day together. We did like a collab, and that's why we're hanging out today, because like we're like Valentine's Day buddies. If you guys are new, this channel is Ask Kimberly. I'm Kimberly. I'm a relationship counselor. I have a doctoral degree in psychology, and I answer relationship questions on this channel. We have like the best little community on YouTube. I love it so much. Like, welcome to the family. And make sure, if you are loving our conversation tonight, if you want relationship advice, definitely subscribe, because it's an amazing community of people here. I put out 2 videos a week on relationships, and Nikki's channel is Health Nut Nutrition. She does like really interesting and fun and healthy recipes that I think she's super talented and creative, and everything is so beautiful on her channel. It's inspirational. So go subscribe to her and make sure for both of us, like, you click that notification bell to make sure that you're getting notified each time we go live or we publish a new video.
Because it's nice to come on these chats, like, even though you can watch them after, it's nice to be live so that you can actually engage in the conversation.
I know, ask
a question that you want to ask him. And if you hit that bell notification button, then you'll actually get like a notification, like, you know, Ask Kimberly is live right now, and then you can just like go watch, even if you're like out and about and just want to watch for a few minutes, or, you know, sit for the whole thing.
Well, that's exactly it. And I feel like with live, I'll get a chance, because I answer so many of your questions, but like there's literally thousands of questions. It's so overwhelming for me. Like, I can't ever get to all of them. I can't even read all of them. So doing this live chat is an amazing way to actually interact with you guys live. And hopefully eventually I'll actually get to answering more of the questions. This channel makes me happy. Oh, I love you guys. Okay. Insecurities. Okay. So let's chat about insecurities, and then we might have to wrap up. Like, I feel like it's almost time to wrap this up, you guys. Who's having fun Valentine's Day? Who's having an amazing Valentine's Day? I'm eating more cake. Whoa, that was a big bite. It's like all melted.
It's like ice cream soup.
I'm just going to take like one of the huge cookie dough chunks. Oh my God, look at this. It's like, it is actually like ice cream soup. I don't know.
It looks like a melted snowman, because there's like the buttons, like the chocolate chips are the buttons.
Damn. You guys made my Valentine's Day special. Oh, I love you guys so much. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for hanging out with us on Valentine's Day. It's like Galentine's Day. We got ice cream, we got flowers, we got chocolates. This was so fun.
Who needs the boys? They're like
seriously,
off.
They're watching hockey right now.
Drinking beers.
Funny.
They're like in the man cave over there.
So funny. But yeah, insecurities. Let's talk about, can we talk about insecurities? Do you guys want to know like how to get over insecurities? Someone say, is my shirt too low? Sorry. I had major insecurities growing up. Did you?
Yeah, I feel like, it's funny because things that like, I think I used to care about, I'd still like, they bother me a little bit now, but like I wouldn't get upset or about them. I don't know. I think like even with Matt, it's like things that bothered me in the beginning, like, you know, don't bother me at all. Like,
yeah.
Things about like things maybe you don't like about your body and stuff. And then you realize like everybody has those things. And like when Matt looks at me, he thinks like, you know, like, oh, you're perfect. He doesn't look at the things that are in my head that like, I don't like this about me. I don't like that about me. So like those things that I used to be insecure about, like I'm not with Matt anymore, but that's different. Cause like we've been together for a long time that like, and Matt is just not the type of person to, I guess, like point out, you know, cause some guys are right. Like some guys or girls, like they will point out things that it's almost because they have their own insecurities that they want to point out yours.
Yeah. And if someone ever does that to you guys, like if anyone ever like criticizes you for something like about your body or like picks you apart, like don't be with that person. That's not,
it's
a good
quality.
It's not
healthy.
That's terrible.
You should both be rooting for this for the same team and not be picking on each other about like, oh, you're like, I don't know, your ears are weird, or like, oh, you're, you know, your butt's too small, or I don't know.
Oh my God, yeah, or like you need to work out and lose some weight. Like I feel like that's a terrible, like if anyone ever says that to you, like,
just leave them.
Yeah, that's a terrible, terrible thing to say. Mm-hmm. Yeah, seriously. When I was growing up, I had like major body insecurities, and I always thought like I grew up in the performing arts and a lot of stuff like in front of an audience, and so I think like that definitely perpetuated it for me, especially in dance and singing and stuff. But I think like as you get older and as you kind of go through different relationships, you kind of realize like it doesn't really matter what anybody else thinks, and most of the images that you guys see, that we all see on TV and in the media, are like super photoshopped. They're super like airbrushed and everything.
Yeah, they're altered. Yeah,
they are altered. And not only that, but the people who are in those images are like not, they don't represent the average population. Like they are literally like stick figures. Like I'm telling you, like when you actually meet some of these people in person, you're like, oh my God, you're way too skinny. And so I think it took me a really long time to actually understand that. So I think like everybody is beautiful in their own skin, and like I think as soon as I accepted, like, to be confident in your own skin is the most important thing. And, like, your body's never... you can alter your body a little bit, but you really can't change what you've been given.
Like, you have... you're going to live with your body for the rest of your life. Like, might as well...
treat it well.
Yeah, you know, create a healthy relationship with your body and stuff. Like, for me, I always... from, like, even at a young age, I always made it a point not to compare myself in, you know... when we were younger, it was more so like magazines were a huge thing, like Cosmopolitan and all those things. And like, I knew so many friends that'd be like, oh my God, like how pretty she is. And and that's great to say someone's pretty, but if you're putting yourself down as if you're not as pretty or they're prettier than you and you're making yourself feel like crap about it, then like that's not a healthy thing to say.
Yeah.
So I would always, you know, like close the magazine, be like, don't compare yourself. Like,
don't.
You know, you're pretty in your own way. They're pretty in their own way. They also have a whole team making themselves look that certain way. And like you're saying, a lot of times you meet these people in person and they don't actually look
healthy
or like as pretty as they did in the, like it's very deceiving. So
very deceiving.
Just like don't compare yourself to other people, because like whoever you end up being with or for a relationship or marrying or whatever, like they're gonna like love you for your uniqueness and not you look like a Barbie, you know?
Yeah. And did you guys watch, I don't know if you guys saw this on TV, but the Miss Universe pageant, did you see it?
No, you're telling me about it though.
Oh my God, it was so good. Well, okay, like I don't like I, it's weird because like I like, it's entertaining to watch a pageant, but at the same time, you're like, ugh.
The meaning behind it, you're kind of like, ugh.
Yeah, like, perfect girl means, like, a certain look. Like, they don't have to be, like, necessarily, like, the most intelligent person, but they have to look really good in a bathing suit, and that concept really bothers me. But at the same time, Miss Canada, we're from Canada, we're from Toronto, we're in Toronto right now. Miss Canada was, like, plus size, but she wasn't actually plus size. She was just, like, a normal girl.
Yeah.
But she was, like, boom, boom, boom. Like, she was, like, so confident, and she was amazing. Like, I loved, loved, loved watching it.
Yeah.
She didn't win, but it was so inspiring, just so inspiring to watch her, like, just not be ashamed of her body and, like, be super proud of herself.
Yeah. No, I know. I love seeing stuff like that. But it is crazy, because when you do see, like, the plus size models, you're like, that's like a normal, like, I don't know. I feel like I hate that that's like plus size and it's not just like normal.
Yeah.
You know?
Like she's, yeah. Cause all of the other ones are like dieting and exercising like crazy before. And they're like 6 feet tall, right?
Yeah. And she's just embracing her natural like curves and stuff. And it's like
plus
size, you know, I'm like, that's like,
that's crazy.
It's like me after a meal. Like that's, you know, like, but that's awesome though.
Yeah, absolutely.
Go Canada.
Oh, I love you guys. Love yourself. Oh, we love us. Kimberly is here. Oh, you guys should go follow her on Instagram and YouTube.
Kira, her handle is We Love Ask Kimberly, and she's like the best fan ever. I have some amazing fans, you guys. You guys are just awesome. Jack is back. Oh, gosh. Oh, my goodness. Go get a life, Jack. Seriously. everyone's saying Jack is back.
I love that.
All right, you guys. So this is Valentine's Day. If you are new, I'm Kimberly. This channel is Ask Kimberly. This is Nikki. She's from Health Not Nutrition. We did a collab for Valentine's Day. That's why we're hanging out today. We thought it would be just like a really fun idea to like get some snacks and get the guys together and like have a live stream. And this is like my first YouTube live stream ever. So I think we'll be doing it a lot more often. Guys, definitely subscribe to both of our channels if you haven't already and click that little notification bell. Okay, two things. We are giving away a Kylie lip kit and in the shade of Love Bite and three $100 gift cards to Baskin Robbins for the most embarrassing stories, for really crush stories in the comments here. So we're looking on Instagram and we're looking in the comments here. So definitely keep sharing your stories, and we are going to be reviewing all the comments after this and choosing our favorite ones.
I can't wait to read them.
Love Bite. Ah, Sydney. Yeah, it's an amazing shade. It's an amazing shade. You guys, we have been streaming now for 105 minutes. It is almost time for us to say goodbye. So I really want to thank you, Nikki, for coming over tonight.
And for inviting us over.
Oh my gosh, this has been so much fun. Well, guys, definitely let us know if you want us to live stream again, because yeah, I feel like it was so fun, and like I love like actually seeing your comments there. I know you guys. No. I love you so much. But don't worry, we'll do it again. I feel like every Friday we should do this. Like,
I know, I want to start live streaming on my channel like on a weekly thing. Because yeah. I've done a little bit of like live stuff here and there, and it's just like the experience is so different than just posting a video and then like, you know, it's like a two-way conversation, but it's like, you know, leaving comments and then we're answering them. But like the live interaction is just like a really cool experience.
And I don't always get to answer all of your questions. Like there's like, I'll try to get to like, but it's just, you guys know it's impossible, right? Even the Snapchats, like I can't like once in a while I'll see them and I'll try to write something quickly back, but it's like, I would spend all day every day just answering things. So I love you guys. And that's one thing that actually like breaks my heart sometimes, is like, I can't actually personally respond to like each and every comment. It hurts. So I like this idea, because I like, even though I'm not actually responding to all the comments here, and I'm sorry about that, at least we can see them, and at least like, you know, I really feel the love from you guys, and like hopefully you feel that from me too, and that's why I continue to do this. So I love you guys. Thank you so much for joining us for Valentine's Day. This has probably been like my funnest Valentine's Day ever. It's been so great. Like, we had Cassie yesterday, we gave her some ice cream cake, and like we all hung out as a family, and like tomorrow Nathan and I are going for like a really romantic dinner, and like tonight it's like friends, you know, friends on YouTube. So
it's a good like mix of everything.
Yeah,
family,
definitely.
Friends.
Yeah, exactly. So we are gonna sign off, you guys. To give you big kisses. I hope you guys all have an amazing Valentine's night. I love you guys so much, and we will see you. I'm putting out another Q&A on Friday.
In our next video.
In our next video. Guys, stay tuned for the Q&A on Friday. It's so good. It's so good. Oh my God. It's so good. Bye, guys. I love you so much. Bye. Mwah, 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 mwah. Bye. Oh my gosh. My battery's dying too. Okay. I'm actually going to hang up now. I love you guys.
Bye, guys.
Oh, wait. Do you guys want to say goodbye to the boys?
Oh, we'll see.
I'm sorry. We should.
It's only polite.
It's only proper. Okay. Here we go. I think my foot is asleep right now. You guys want to say bye?
Bye.
Yeah.
Bye.
There's bye. Matt. Bye.
Bye.
There's Nathan.
Come back next time for my and Nathan's relationship advice.
Yeah. Oh my God. They're telling you guys, come back next time.
All the dirt.
They're telling you guys to come back next time for Matt and Nathan's relationship. Wouldn't that be funny? If it's like Matt and Nathan's corner.
I guarantee you find true love in a week.
Yeah. Oh, snap.
True love in a week.
I love you guys. I'm gonna actually hang up this time. Okay.